Hey up everyone, right, so tonight's the night for the England football team, semi-final against Denmark, whatever. This is like, I mean, I've seen England get to semi-finals before. It's kind of weird being an England supporter. I mean, I get a lot of stick, like, from leftists and stuff because I support England. And like, do you know, like, I've got Irish ancestry, I've got Scotch on my dad's side of family, they're all Scottish. So I could support Ireland or Scotland or England, but I got brought up to support England, do you know what I mean? And the thing about football is, you pick your team when you're a kid and that's it, you stick with them forever no matter what, do you know what I mean? And it is quite difficult being an England supporter, like, because There's just loads of racism around fucking England supporters, and they sing racist songs and stuff like that, do you know what I mean? And like with like football hooliganism and stuff, right, whatever, it's always massively political. So like Liverpool's football hooligans and Man United's football hooligans, they're all socialists, yeah. And then like Leeds United and other teams, they've got fascists who support them, yeah. But with England, it's mainly fascists who support them, yeah. And they go around the world following England, shouting fascist shit. So it's quite difficult being an England supporter. But whatever, you choose your team when you're a kid, and that's it, you've got to stick with them, do you know what I mean? But it's also weird being an England supporter, because, like, do you know, like, my Premier League team, my like, first football team is Liverpool. And, like, Liverpool are one of the best teams in the world. And throughout my life, I've seen Liverpool win everything that it's possible for them to win. I've seen us win everything, do you know what I mean? So basically, I've been supporting a very successful football team. But then I support England, who are not a successful team at all, do you know what I mean? So I've got both the what it's like to support a really good team and what it's like to support a shit team. And like, you know, I don't particularly like international football, and I don't generally watch any friendlies or anything like that. But when there's a competition on, either Euros or World Cup or whatever, then whatever, I support my team, do you know what I mean? And we've got to semi-finals, and the thing is, we're playing Denmark. Denmark, do you know what I mean? They're not really a big team. We should beat them, do you know what I mean? The thing is as well, is that for the first time in a long time, probably from about 96 or whatever, Euro 96, we've actually got a good team and we're actually playing some really good football. I've been quite impressed with the way that England have been playing. We're playing some good football. So the thing is that, like, everybody's just assuming that we're going to beat Denmark, right? And I think we will. I think we'll beat them. And then that means we get to the final. The final. And this will be the first time that I've ever seen England get to a final. I've never seen them get to a final before, because they've never got to a final. All of my life, England have never won anything. They've never won a single competition ever throughout my entire life. I'm 50 years of age. The last time we won something was in 1966. I wasn't even born then. I wasn't even born. So, like, all my life, I've had to listen to old blokes telling me what it was like when we won World Cup and stuff, yeah? And I've never experienced that. I've never experienced England winning anything, yeah, ever in my life. I've seen us get to a couple of semi-finals before, but we always get knocked out, usually by Germany. But anyhow, we started off the old foe earlier on in this competition. So Denmark, aye. I think we'll beat them. I do. I think we've got a good team, and we've been playing some really good football. We seem to have a good manager and stuff. So I'm really confident about this game, going into this game, that we're really going to beat them, and we're going to get to a fucking final, man. Whatever. And also, we know who we're playing in the final. It's going to be Italy, right? That's not going to be an easy game. If England get to final against Italy, Italy have been playing some really good football. Italy have gone 33 games unbeaten. 33 games, that's ridiculous. So if we get to final, It's not going to be. That's not going to be an easy game at all. Which then, but that'll make it even better because if we win, oh my god, if England win something. Oh, I've waited all my life to see England win something. But like, if England won against Italy, then it'd be like a really good win because it'd be a win against a really good team. Do you know what I mean? You don't want to play somebody who's shit. Do you know what I mean? You want it to be a good game, a good game of football, and best team comes out on top. Do you know what I mean? That's what you want. So it'd be really good. It'd be a really good game against Italy. I think it'd be a really good final. I wouldn't know who to say would win that game. I think it's a toss-up. It's a 50-50. I think either team could win it, but like Italy's a really good team, but so is England. England are playing really good football as well. So don't know. It'd be a good final. But anyhow, we've got this game to get through first. Denmark. 8 o'clock, 3 hours time. Kick off. I'm getting a bit nervous, a bit excited. I started drinking alcohol. Get ready for the game. So yeah, come on, England!